Welcome to the ePASRR Level 1 training for hospitals and community agencies. In this video, we will show you how to search for a patient, add a patient, and complete a Level 1 screening in the ePASRR application. Every patient being admitted to a Medicaid-certified nursing facility must have a pre-admission screening completed prior to admission. To complete the Level 1 screening in ePASRR, use the right navigation bar and select Search for Patients. Enter the patient's name or ID number and select Search. Locate the correct patient in the grid below and select the patient. If the patient does not exist in ePASRR, use the link to add a new patient. Once you select an existing patient or create a new patient profile, the patient management page will open. You will see the patient demographic information, options for completing a PASRR packet, and all the PASRR packets that have previously been created for the patient. You have two options to complete a Level 1 PASRR packet. If you select New 1178, a blank form will open for you to complete. If you select Copy Existing 1178, all Level 1 forms available for copying will appear in the grid below. Select the Copy button next to the packet that you would like to copy. For this training, we will create a new 1178 by choosing the New 1178 Radio button and selecting Create Packet. The DHS 1178 Level 1 PASRR screening form will open. Enter the patient's primary diagnosis and referral source information. Answer all questions in Part A and B by choosing the appropriate radio button. If all answers in Part A and B are no, complete the form by entering the assessor's name, credentials, the date, and time the form was signed. Select Complete Form when you are finished. If any answer in Part A or B is yes, Part C, Categorical Determinations, will open. Answer all questions in Part C by choosing the appropriate radio button. Complete the form by entering the assessor's name, credentials, the date, and time the form was signed. Select Complete Form when you are finished. You will be taken back to the packet management page. The next section you will need to complete is the Referring Entity Contact Information section. Select the Edit button, enter the name and phone number of the person that can be contacted if a nursing facility has a question about the patient. Select Save when you are finished. Scroll down and you will see the completed Level 1 form. If you need to make any changes to the Level 1, select Edit Form. If you would like to view the form or print it, select the View Form button. The last step in completing the Level 1 is to provide supporting documentation. Use the Upload feature to provide medical records, such as a history and physical, a medication list, or a psychiatric evaluation. Select the Browse button and search for the file you would like to upload. Select the Upload button and you will see the file appear in the grid below. If the patient is being admitted to a nursing facility that has access to your electronic medical record system, you can check the box that says the nursing facility has access to the referring entity's electronic medical record and can view supporting documentation that validates the Level 1, in lieu of uploading medical records. Select the Finalize Level 1 Process button when you are finished. If the Level 1 is positive for serious mental illness or intellectual or developmental disability, and a categorical determination was not selected, you will need to complete the Level 2 evaluation. Watch the ePASRR Level 2 training for hospitals and community agencies for step-by-step instructions. If the Level 1 was negative or positive with a categorical determination, the Patient Placement section will open next. This is where you will select the nursing facilities you want to view the patient information for potential admission to the nursing facility. Click the plus sign next to the island name to expand the section. Select the checkbox next to the nursing facilities being considered for the patient. There is no limit on the number of nursing facilities that can be selected. When finished, select the Save NF Placement Selections button. You will see the selected nursing facility or facilities appear in the grid below. These facilities now have access to view the patient's PASRR packet for 7 days. If after 7 days a placement decision has not been made, the nursing facilities will disappear from the grid. You can go back into the PASRR packet and select the nursing facilities again to restart another 7-day review period. Once a placement decision has been made, you will go to the patient placement grid and use the select button corresponding to the facility accepting the patient. All other facilities in the grid will disappear. Select the complete packet button and the PASRR packet is completed. Thank you for watching the ePASRR Level 1 training for hospitals and community agencies. If you have any questions, an ePASRR Frequently Asked Questions Guide with step-by-step instructions is available under the Resources and Instruction tab in ePASRR. Or feel free to call us at 808-941-1444 or email ePASRRsupport@hsag.com.